Hey everyone, I'm Aliena, I'm a self-taught uiux designer and welcome back to my channel. Today I want to share some tools that I've been using as a uiux designer. These tools have helped me a lot when it comes to visualizing my ideas, communicating with PMs, engineers and other stakeholders, managing my time, documenting my process, and also just declutter my brain. And let's get started with the first major design tool that I use is Figma. I think most companies these days are either using Figma or trying to transfer from another app to Figma. Figma is great for design work, communication, collaboration, prototyping, and it also has a huge community page where you can pretty much just store other templates. For example, this TripMap file is something I downloaded from the Figma community page. And based on my understanding, this is a website that helps you to book a plane ticket. Usually, if you are working with a company that has existing product, you'll be working with an existing design system. And in this case, it's located here at the components page. Usually it's not like this. Usually it's in another different Figma file where it just says design system for this company. And you can just pretty much copy whatever components are available in there and paste it in the new design that you want to create. And one thing I use a lot in a Figma file is this chat function. For example, if I need some help with like the content design work, which is the text, you can either just click a place or you can create a box of the place where you want to comment on a design. Help me with this design. Something like this. So usually the content designer will also be using the chat function a lot, telling me what text to put into different places. I think if you are new to this field, Figma is definitely the go-to design software you should start learning and start playing around with. And whenever you feel lost, you can always go to the Figma community page and check out other people's design. Check out some plugins and some widgets that can be very fun to play with. Something that I've been struggling with when I was first entering the field of UI/UX design is that I don't know how to organize my design file so that it looks organized. So if you've encountered a similar problem and you want to learn more about how I organize my design file, please comment banana in the comment section below and I will make a video on that, and let's also confuse the people who haven't watched it this far. The next tool that I want to introduce is very helpful for documentation and task management, and that is Coda. Coda is a new type of all-in-one interactive dog, and it also blends the best of docs, spreadsheets, presentations, and applications into one surface. Coda is also the sponsor of this video, so thank you very much. Usually when it comes to designers, we have weekly stand-up meeting or bi-weekly stand-up meeting. And by the way, if you have daily stand-up meetings, I'm so sorry for you. So what happens in the stand-up meetings that designers will share what we'll be doing for this week? And is there any new project? Do you need help from other people when it comes to a project? And in Coda, it looks something like a project tracker. And you can always create a new project tracker when you first come to Coda by clicking Starter Templates and Project Tracker. Just imagine that the project name will be the project name of everybody's project. And for assignee, it will be 1, 2, 3 designers or other POs that's responsible for the project. And for the status, it can be pending, in progress, completed, backlog. Usually I'm not the person who needs to change any of the tags or status. I will just be saying it out and someone in the meeting will help me to change the status if necessary. But something good about this is that we can always provide some clear documentation when it comes to progress by expanding a row and adding a comment. And that has been something that's really helpful for me. And another great thing about Coda is that it works well with other tools like Figma. So if you're at Coda's website, you can go to My Workspace and then click Templates, See More, and search for design. This design to-do list is a perfect demonstration of how it works with Figma. So click Create, and you can link the document with your Figma account. And here it gives a little bit of demonstration of how it might look once you link it with your file. It will show the name of the screen and also the image of the screen of how it looks like. And this is a page that's really helpful when it comes to communicating with my design manager and also the product owner of the project. Now, another thing I like to do with Coda is basically just documenting whatever meetings I have, whatever's on my mind, anything that's related to my work. And recently, I've been obsessed with this new thing. So go to my workspace, go to template again, and see more. There's this 30-day decluttering challenge, which I really think I need to do. So I'm just clicking create for now. It's like a calendar for a 30 days challenge for you to declutter your bedroom and your digital device. I think this is just really, really helpful. And the fact that it is placed in the first slot of the templates just shows how many people are using it right now. I mean, I really need to declutter. Yeah. And that's it for Coda. Also, please check out Coda with the link below, and it is completely free. And I hope that with Coda, you don't have to have 100 tabs open in your browser or 100 documents open in your laptop. Now moving to the next tool, which is a tool that helps me to communicate with the software engineers, and that's Zeplin. Basically, Zeplin is available on website, and also it is a plugin for Figma. Zeplin's website is at app.zeplin.io. And if you want to communicate with a software engineer and show that this is the final design, you can create first project, web, create, and I will give it a title, Tripma. And then I can select the screens that I want to upload. For now, I'll just select three screens as a demo. And I will right click, select plugins, Zeplin, export, and select Tripma. Go back to Zeplin and you'll be able to see the screens here. Now, when you click it, it will show a lot of details that's very helpful for the front-end software engineers. And going back, you can also divide these screens into different sections using the divide and sign in between and name it to the user flow you want to name it. And if you want to go deeper, you can also check out flows and style guide. And this software is also free to explore. Now, regarding communicating with software engineers and front-end engineers, Zeplin is again just a tool. I think the most important thing is to communicate before we do a design project, because a lot of time, maybe product manager suggested a feature, designers design a feature, all the UI UX are finished, and then we go to engineers, and then we heard back that, oh, sorry, this is not gonna happen soon. And yeah, even though it's a lot of communication, it's always better than going through a linear process and knowing that your design will never be implemented, right? And speaking of communication, one communication tool that I use all the time is Slack. Basically, what Slack does is that it kind of replaces email. I personally really don't like email because I just feel like email is too heavy. Especially when you have a lot of back and forth communication, when you ask one question, the person replies you, and then you want to ask another question, it just becomes a never-ending list. Well, it should really become a chat, and that's why I think Slack is really, really helpful when it comes to communication. So here's the interface. I cannot show you my work interface, and that's why this is a very empty look. Basically, you can just send a message like this, and I love the reaction little feature. You can always like react to other people's message by an emoji. That's great. And I also ask for a lot of design feedback on Slack. Sometimes I have this version A and this version B that I don't know which one to go for. I'll just send it to three designers and be like, what do you think for each version? And do you have any design suggestions for me? I think it's a great thing to always ask for other people's feedback, because no matter how good a designer you are you. You represent one point of view. If you ask more people for more point of view, I think it's just always going to make it a little bit better and a little bit more comprehensive. So yeah, ask for design feedback, maybe on Slack, maybe on text, maybe email, I don't care. But yeah, this is one thing that I found helpful. Now moving to the next tool that I use as a UX designer, that is Zoom. Zoom is for video chatting, video conferencing. So for me, a lot of design sessions actually happens on Zoom because it is a collaborative session with other designers, product owners, content designers. And what I'll be doing as a new designer is that I'll be sharing my screen so that other people can be commenting on my design and add ideas to it. And a lot of times, my work will just be sitting there and try to realize other people's thoughts, which is definitely a challenging process because, you know, when other people are all seeing your screen and you're just like the only designer there making a lot of unnecessary mistakes, sometimes it's a little bit embarrassing. But again, that's my work. Something that I recently learned is that whenever you want to say something, you don't have to use your mouth to click unmute. You can just press the space on the keyboard and it will just temporarily unmute yourself. And if you don't use the space, it will just mute it again. So that has been something that's very helpful. Another thing I realized is that recently, if you go to preferences, go to background and filters, they have this studio effects, which can apply super weird makeup to yourself. And they really don't suggest you to use it because I've used it once and it just looks very scary. I don't know why they designed this eyebrow. Okay, I just shared a super unuseful tip. Anyways, another thing I like about Zoom is that you can always give reactions by doing this reaction little thing and just give an emoji, you know? A lot of time, I am an introvert. I don't like to say a lot in a meeting, so I just always give this emoji to make people feel like I'm still here, I'm still listening, and I'm still supporting. And also for Zoom, please make sure that when you first enter a company, you set up your Zoom in a way so that you're able to share your screen. Because when I first entered eBay, I realized that my laptop is not allowing to share screen on Zoom for some reason, and I have to spend a lot of time working with the IT guy to figure out how to make that happen. And finally, the final tool I want to introduce you guys is Microsoft Outlook. And that's something I use every day for email and for calendar because Outlook combines calendar and email all at once. If I want to book a meeting with someone, I will be able to see that person's calendar and when is that person available. If I want to book a meeting with four people, I can see all of their calendar and the slot that's available on Outlook. So that's pretty useful for me. And I think it's also okay to book meeting with yourself too, you know. Just say you are having a focus time for 2 hours, even though what I'll be doing is that I'll be doing groceries. And again, I think the best tool to use as a UI UX designer is always our brain. It's just that we cannot put that into our resume. So to have some like tangible software to know, it's still a great way to start if you want to enter this field of UI UX design or if you want to become a better UI UX designer. I also want to give a quick shout out to Harshita for helping me with today's video. She is a product manager at Coda. She also has a YouTube channel at Harshibar. So if you want to learn more about what it's like to work in the tech industry, feel free to check out her video. And if you like my video, don't forget to subscribe, like, and comment. More content's coming up soon, and see you next time!